Do you know which other car or plane burns more fuel to carry you from one place to one other? In other words, if you want to travel from city A to city B while using as little fuel as possible, should you go by car or by plane? In this video, I'm going to show you how to deal with the various variables that you need to analyze to find the answer. And to make it simpler, let's take an example. Let's pick a popular car and a popular plane and calculate how much fuel it takes for each of them to go from A to B. For the car, what about a Toyota Corolla, which is the best seller of all times, and it looks roughly like this. And for the plane, let's go with the Boeing 737, the most popular plane in commercial aviation, and here is what it looks like. Alright, let's go through the numbers. How much fuel does each of them burn? On a highway at 60 mph, a Corolla burns roughly 1.8 gallons per hour. Okay, so how much is 1.8 gallons per hour exactly? To help us compare the fuel flows, I built this experiment with colored water. The left-hand side is for the car, and right now it is set up to 1.8 gallons per hour. Wow, this is a very thin stream of fuel, but in fact, that's all the Corolla needs to drive you at 60 miles per hour. Now, how many gallons per hour do you think a plane burns in cruise? Any idea? Here's a number. In cruise, the Boeing 737 burns 725 gallons per hour. Holy cow, this is a lot of fuel. Actually, it is 400 times more than the car. In the experiment, the hose was not even big enough to accommodate the fuel flow. What you see here is the fuel flow of only one of the engines. But since the plane has two engines, this is what the fuel flow of the plane in cruise really looks like. Pretty impressive. So it looks like the plane burns a lot more fuel than the car. But this comparison is not really fair, since the plane also carries a lot more passengers. As a matter of fact, in the US, the average number of passengers in a car is only 1.6. Whereas a Boeing 737 carries, in average, 144 passengers. Therefore, the comparison would be more fair if we considered the fuel flow per passenger instead, which is the quantity of fuel per hour that a car or a plane needs to carry one passenger. For the car, we have 1.8 gallons per hour divided by 1.6 passengers, which makes 1.1 gallon per hour per passenger. Now for the plane, 725 gallons per hour divided by 144 passengers yields 5.0 gallons per hour per passenger. Have you noticed how much closer the numbers are? Now, this is what it looks like in the experiment. These are the fuel flows divided by the average number of passengers for the car on the left and for the plane on the right. The fuel flows are now much closer, but the plane still appears to be thirstier than the car. However, we're still missing something in this comparison. The plane is moving much faster than the car, so it will take less time to cover the same distance. Remember that we're trying to find which one of the car or the plane requires less fuel to go from city A to city B, or in other words, to cover a given distance. Let's take an example. To cover 1 mile, the plane takes 7 seconds. Whereas the car needs 1 minute. Now, let's have a look at the amount of fuel that the car and the plane need with our experiment. The fuel flows are exactly the same than before, but now we're going to collect the fuel for the amount of time needed by the car and the plane to cover 1 mile. As we said, the plane is flying much faster than the car, and you can see in the animation at the top that it has already arrived. The amount of liquid you see in the cup on the right-hand side is exactly the amount of fuel that the Boeing 737 requires to carry one passenger over 1 mile. Meanwhile, the car keeps driving, as you can see on the animation on the top. And the amount of fuel in the cup on the left already exceeds that of the plane on the right. What we've seen with this experiment is that comparisons of fuel consumptions between different means of transportation are not necessarily as simple as they may appear. In fact, a Boeing 737 burns an enormous quantity of fuel compared to a Corolla. But because it carries a lot more passengers and also moves much faster, it actually requires less fuel to carry one passenger over 1 mile. And here comes the proof! Both glasses contain the amount of fuel to carry one passenger over 1 mile, but on the left side we're using a car, whereas on the right side we're using a plane. So just finishing off with the actual numbers. If we divide the fuel flow per passenger per the speed, 60 miles per hour for the Corolla and 515 miles per hour for the Boeing 737, we obtain the amount of fuel per passenger per mile. For the car, this number is 0.018 gallons per passenger per mile, or 2.4 fluid ounces per passenger per mile. Now for the plane, we only need half of this, 1.2 fluid ounces per passenger per mile.